I made and talking about those, but also trying to come to grips, as I write in the book, about everything from, you know, sexism and misogyny to voter suppression, to the unusual behavior of the former director of the FBI and the Russians. And the Russians, and you have been sounding the alarm about this, because I believe so strongly that they think they succeeded in messing with our democracy, and I just can't abide that. So,
do you think they succeeded in messing with
our
democracy?
Yes, I do. I do.
Because to what degree, like influencing the vote or influencing opinion?
Influencing voters and therefore influencing opinion, I think, is becoming clearer and clearer. I don't know what the congressional investigations, and I don't know what the special counsel investigation are going to find. I'm going to wait for that. But I don't think anybody can, with a straight face, say that the Russians did not set out to influence our election, and they did so. This latest revelation about the way they bought ads on Facebook and targeted them, we're going to find out a lot more, Stephen. And I am saying as clearly as I can, I feel like I'm a bit of a, you know, Paula Revere, I'm trying to sound the alarm about this, is that the, you know, you've got to understand what Putin's strategy is. He really doesn't like democracy. He thinks it's an inconvenient, messy process. And he doesn't like us. And he wants to destabilize our country, sow doubt about our democracy. I mean, these latest revelations where you had Russians pretending to be Americans, so you had fake Americans with fake news and fake stories and fake demonstrations, that wasn't just because he's bored and has nothing to do. He wants to undermine how we see each other, how we respect each other, how we support our institutions and our society. So I think that they believe they had a good outing in 2016, and I think they will be back in 2018 and 2020 unless we stop them.
Now, you mentioned